Hey guys, so Samufacturing here again. In this video, I'm gonna show you how I terminate and how SoundTools terminates the SuperCAT sound cable. It's a little bit different than the SuperCAT cable and honestly just a little bit more annoying, but it's because the cable's more durable and it's worth it probably. It's a good cable. But as with last time, if you haven't watched the other video, also go watch that. But, because I don't know if I'm going to cover things. I don't know how videos work, so hopefully this is good enough. But, as with last time, this is going to be the what we're making, and this is our unterminated side. So, we're going to start with this, end with this. So, as with last time, we go with the shrink wrap, which we just put on SoundTools products, so you can add labels. And this one's just a little bit of a bigger shrink wrap, because this is a bigger cable. The products, there's just a little bit more stuff stuffed into this one, and the shielding is a little bit thicker, and it's just a more durable cable, which is why it's also rad. You put the shrink wrap on, you put the boot on. Getting the boot on is a lot more annoying because it is a thicker cable, so you wanna make sure you can put it on there and it doesn't get all bunched up, which that one was actually surprisingly easy. So thank you, boot, for disproving that putting you on is annoying, I guess. I guess it's just an aesthetic thing, but we make sure that this is all outward. Then for stripping the cable, we use this guy instead of the other guy. And still, even then, we still have a little bit of hold, but here we are. When we pull it out, unlike the SuperCAT cable, we have three pieces of this cotton, which I'm assuming is also for similar anti-stretch purposes, and four shielded pairs. And that contains a bunch of fancy stuff that I might get to. But first, we're just gonna snip this little anti-stretch cotton off. Boop. You're not gonna slice your finger, because I've definitely done that multiple times. So now we have all of these little guys. This is covered in plastic and also a metal that we basically just wanna get rid of. There's just so much junk in here. It's good because, really the only interactions I've had with cat cables is running them to front of house on tour and being overly concerned about them being run over by forklifts if the yellow jackets are not closed. And theoretically, this one is more durable to deal with being run over with forklifts, which I suppose in the end makes all of this junk that you have to get through to terminate it worth it. But also no promises, I suppose. I don't know what these are capable of. They're supposed to be really durable, and that's all I know. And also, my dad designed them, and that's cool. Shoutouts to Mr. Dave Rat. And this is me filling time while I just cut off the multitudes of metal and plastic that surround these. This motion is really helpful, I find, for it. Just this like kind of twisting motion, because it really loosens it up. Quite honestly, what I generally do is I do take a little razor blade to the edges of it, but that's also because I have very skilled hands with these guys at this point. You don't really want to do that, especially if you're only doing one, because you can cut these guys and we don't want to cut those guys. But also, I've just done a bajillion of these and this takes a very long time. So I'm gonna show you all this one. But now, after all of that, we still have paper and these little rubber things to get rid of, because really, realistically, the most time-consuming part of terminating the SuperCAT cable is removing all of the junk that makes it a durable cable. You want to cut close so that there isn't a bunch of junk, because the least, like, down here, because the less junk you have down here, the more stable your termination is going to be at the end, because the closer to the base you're going to be able to get your actual RJ45 connector, I find. So I probably would, yeah, I don't know. Just get it as close as you can. I'm doing it a little bit fast right now because I don't want to just have a 40-minute video of me cutting these things. But here we are. So now we have what we would have gotten to so easily with the SuperCAT cables. All of our wires exposed. The big difference here is that instead of just one shield that we had that we unbraided, we have these four little drain wires. This allows you to do a lot of things that other cables don't, which is really rad. Like the cattails, you can make them without doing all sorts of unnecessary and really big clunky stuff. And just the fact that you have all of these separate drain wires and all these separate like bits make it a very unique cable. So now we are back to just our basic standard RJ45 pattern that we use that we'll probably have a link in the description to, because again, I don't fully understand all of that good fun stuff. But for what we do, broken up green, solid green. Broken up orange, solid blue. So we kind of put these in our basic pattern. Broken up blue, solid orange. Broken up brown, solid brown. So now that we kind of have it vaguely in the right position, we take our little tray. This is our little tray. It looks, as I said in the last video, I was going to show you guys the two types of connections that we use. So the last one, we use the white one. Again, I have no idea about the product number, but there is a product number that goes with it. And then there's these ones. I know that these ones are a little bit more expensive, and these are generally what we use on the SuperCAT sound cables. The tray looks a little bit different. Instead of all of the little holes being in just a row, it's that like four of them are a little bit more raised than the other four. And I don't know, people have their preferences, but a lot of us think it makes it a little bit easier to terminate, because instead of just grabbing the first four in the pattern, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna grab the middle four, which means the broken up brown or broken up orange, solid blue, broken up blue, solid orange. And we're going to actually put these ones in first, leaving the outer two on both sides together. So here we are, and we're just going to put these in the little lower bed. I guess you have to do it in a certain way. I do the raised bed on top with the green on the right, or green on the left and the brown on the right. I hope that doesn't get messed up in video stuff, because I barely know my lefts and rights. It's not a strong suit of mine, but then you put your browns in, and you put your greens in, and here we are with a mostly set up, terminated little SuperCAT sound guy. So again, you kind of just put these down here. Now that I have this in here, I'm gonna twist these little ground wires. I like to wait till the end so I know where that they're gonna sit. These guys are a little bit wilier than the ones on the SuperCAT cable, so you kind of have to like twist them tighter, I find, and we'll deal with that in a minute. And you'll lose all your skin on your fingers if you do a bunch of these, but it's okay. So now we're here, you make sure that we have the right pattern, so green, green, orange, blue, blue, orange, brown, brown, and you just make sure that it's like broken up, solid, broken up, solid, broken up, solid, broken up, solid. And we should be good with all eight. Now that we're here, we take our little connector piece, bend it out. Here we are. Again, you measure it up here, but instead of with the white ones where we put it all the way at the top, we want to make sure that these little yellow tabs are at the top. So you kind of line it up the best you can with a little bit of space, especially since you have all this junk down here. It won't sit as easily as the other one. So you kind of push it up, give yourself some space. It might be wiser if you haven't done this before to give yourself even more space. I just like to do it down because it makes it a little bit sturdier. Now we take our little lovely little cable, tiny cable cutting scissors, and just cut across. These cables are a little bit wilier than the other ones. They're a little bit more frustrating. So we'll see how this is going. We'll see if the little tiny cable RJ45 gods are in my favor today. We shall see. And they are not. So getting these guys to fit in there is a little bit more of a bummer, I must say. Because they kind of have minds of their own. And you got to respect their little minds. And just kind of guide them in the right way. You can see that this one's crossing over. You don't want to let them out because it makes it so much more of a bummer. I know that there's little tools that are supposed to help align this part. I've never been able to get them to work for me. So we're going to try again, see if our little guides are... Ooh, oh, oh, I think we're happy, y'all. So sometimes, again, like, especially with these yellow connectors, if things aren't agreeing with you, sticking this little, like, precision tool in here and just pushing can really get you, like, do a lot of good for you. You can sometimes not have to reseat the whole thing, especially if it's just one little wire that's causing you issues. Just sticking that up in there can be your best friend, I will not lie. Because these guys are a little bit, they just really are ambitious and want to do their own thing. So now that we're here, we are going to take our crimping tool, our non-fancy crimping tool, and just crimp it a few times. If you have a fancier crimping tool, you might not have to hit it as many times, but, you know, I like my little guy, so I'm used to him. We've got to know each other after a long time of terminating cables. So now, for a better ground connection, I like to wrap it around twice. We put them in here. This cable is a little bit thicker, so you kind of have to force it on here a little bit more. And you can see that it's not wrapping around as much as, like, as we maybe would like, because this cable is so thick, which is, again, a very good thing. However, you know, we have to work around it a little bit. So you just have to be a little bit more aware, I guess, and mindful when you're connecting this, that you get a good, solid, stable, stable wraparound with those little wires. But as you can see, we're mostly done. We have this little bit here, and we are ready to test our cable. So let's see how that's gonna go. Here's me hoping that I don't have to record this whole video again because I've made a mistake in termination. Here we go, boom. Use our little Klein tool, and we go, boop. And we have a pass. Which is so beautiful to see and so horrible not to see. Take this away, take this away. We do a little snippy snip of these. I like to leave the snipping to the last part because if we have to redo it, it's easier to unwrap and cut off and all of that fun stuff. Cool, I didn't forget the boot. Had a little brief panic when I just imagined not having done the boot right now. We have the boot, we go boom. We take this guy, put him on here, and we make sure he lines up properly. And we go, hello, sitting there happy. We screw it on a little bit. You have to be a little bit more forceful with these ones, I find, than the SuperCAT cables. And it's, again, just because the cable's a little bit thicker, things just sit a little bit differently, and it's all totally fine. You just have to be... The same thing that you would do, I guess, on the SuperCAT cables, you have to just do it a little bit differently on the SuperCAT sounds. So now that we're mostly screwed in here, we're gonna take our testing box and really just tighten it up here. Hone your muscles of wrist turning, and we'll do the same thing here. Oh, and I didn't make sure that we clicked happy, but happy click and happy click. I like to do twice just to make sure. Sometimes it pretends like it's happy and it's not. Gotta make it happy. Okay, and we are good. And the moment of reckoning. And we are happy. Look at this Moomin, we are happy. I must say that having a dog during termination, even though one that you're trying to force to look at things that she doesn't care about, it's a very important part. She's so grumpy with me right now, and that's okay. But, yeah, I hope that that chaotic video was informative and illuminating, and this is our SuperCAT sound cable. And yeah, if you guys have anything you want to see, let us know, and let us know anything else that you want to know. All right, bye guys. Samufacturing out.